Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to talk about a problem that I had recently that was just driving me nuts. So I just updated Illustrator and Photoshop and Bridge, but I hadn't updated InDesign yet. That was still on 2020. So anyway, when I opened up an Illustrator file after this update, all my colors were super saturated. They were almost like neon. And when I would open an InDesign file, I would have the opposite problem. Everything was washed out, dull, ugly. And apparently this is a bug that Adobe's been trying to fix. So I'm going to give you a few different ways to fix it. So the first way to fix this, and this fixed it for me, is to trash your bridge color settings. Now the easy way to do this, especially if you don't really customize your bridge very much, is to quit bridge. So we'll do that. And then as you're restarting bridge, hold shift, option, and command, or control, alt, shift on a PC. So I'm gonna do that now. I'll hold shift, option, and command as it's starting up. And now we get this dialog box to reset the settings. I'm gonna go ahead and click on the first two, and then this last one will already be grayed out. So this will reset all of our preferences and color settings for Bridge. We'll say okay. And then you can also restart Bridge again, although I don't think I had to do that. After I threw away all my preferences, which is just another way of saying reset your preferences, that fixed the problem for me. Now, if that didn't work for you, you'll need to go into whatever program is giving you trouble. So let's go into Illustrator. And now let's hit Command K or Control K on a PC, and that'll bring up your preferences. That's also under Illustrator. I think it's under Edit if you're on a PC. Then we'll come down here to Performance and go ahead and uncheck GPU Performance. Until I found the bridge fix, this actually fixed it for me temporarily. Now, of course, if you do this, you aren't going to be able to use your animated zoom, but that's okay with me. I'm not really crazy about that anyway. So we'll say okay. Now let's go into InDesign and make some changes there. We'll go to Edit and then Color Settings right down here. Now for me, they were set to Emulate Adobe InDesign 2.0 CMS Off. If you're seeing that, you'll want to change to North America General Purpose 2. Or if you're in Europe, you'll probably want to do Europe General Purpose 3. And then say OK. And that also fixed it for me temporarily before I found the bridge thing. Another thing you can try here in InDesign is Edit and then Transparency Blend Space. Your document in the newer version might be set to CMYK instead of RGB here. Just try whatever option is not currently checked. Now, one thing to note is you'll have to be careful with existing documents that have been created with the color settings turned off. So that means they will have been saved with no color profiles. Although I didn't have any problems with Photoshop, apparently some other people were. So if you're having problems with the colors in Photoshop, you'll have to have a document open for this, but you can go to Edit, Color Settings, and then up here you can change this to North America General Purpose 2, like before. You can also go to Edit, Assign Profile, say OK, and then make changes to your profile here. Mine is set at Adobe RGB 1998. So I'm going to leave it at that because my colors look fine here. So here's the thing that's kind of a bummer. If you have documents that you have used when this was happening to you, they are still going to have that color management profile turned off. So you'll have to change it under Document Profiles. And you can usually do that in Edit, Assign Profiles. Anyway, I hope they get this bug fixed soon. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button. And I'll see you next week with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.